In language learning, a language degree is something that is often overlooked. The majority of people learn languages because they're a school requirement and don't give much importance to the goals they may have outside of that. In short, a language degree is an alter ego that is born at the time that we start learning a new language. They're different though, since an alter ego acts as a full new character, and a language ego doesn't grow outside of things like your accent or how fast you learn the language. But what will happen if you let it grow? Most of the time, an alter ego is used to provide courage so a person can do something they don't usually feel comfortable doing, or something they're not allowed to do. Drag queens are amazing examples of alter egos, because they don't only change their personalities, but also their whole outfits, makeup, and hair. Another example you may also be familiar with is Nicki Minaj, who was born to allow Onika to express herself artistically. I have personally used Lex Complex alter egos to allow me to go through experiences that can either be tiring or that cause me anxiety, like when I gave classes for the first time or when I got my first full-time job. I also used to have one that helped me perform in public and give school presentations, which made sure I didn't get a scenic panic and look professional. Using some simple tricks, we can completely change ourselves into an alter ego that tackles the fears we have regarding a language, whether it be your accent or some sort of social pressure. Before you begin, make sure you know exactly which insecurities or beliefs are affecting your learning and how they are affecting it, since it's easier to point out the negative traits when you know the root of them. I have a video explaining in detail what an emotional filter is and how to tackle it if you want to check it out. Once you have that information, you can start creating a character. It doesn't need to have a name nor follow a fashion style, since we want it to be the most practical possible, but if adding that helps you with your process, try to make a separate list from this one so you can reference both and complement them. We're going to focus solely on personality traits here. Korean is the language into which I struggle the most due to some insecurities, so I want to build an alter ego that helps me, especially with speaking. I will take all the negative personality traits that come out when I feel pressure about Korean and put them on one side. They are anxious, shy, fearful, not confident, and get tense when enunciating. Once you're done, you need to think of positive qualities that can overpower the negative ones. For example, I want my alter ego to be brave, very confident, open, funny, kind, and have a happy resting face. That covers most of my issues. I would also advise you to choose a reference accent at this point, because that helps a lot with confidence and fluency. I want my alter ego to have a cute accent, like when Koreans add a ng at the end of every word, but more subtle. Once you're pleased with what you have, you can move on. If you've never had an alter ego, this works by acting like when we were kids and imagine we were secret heroes or celebrities. You just need to imagine how a person with the qualities you chose talks, how they walk, what kind of ideas they have. If that's hard for you to do, look for references that you might like. For example, I chose to have a cute accent after hearing a Korean girl speak in a TikTok video. I just paid attention to what she was doing with her pronunciation and imitated it. You can do the same for all the characteristics in your list, or even choose a person or a character that you look up to and think that will be perfect for this. Make as many notes as you can and reference them as much as you need to. And finally, start practicing! Maybe read a little passage in that language while acting as your new alter ego and get used to it. It doesn't have to be perfect, it just needs to be constant. So make sure you always use this alter ego when interacting with the language you're struggling with. Do it alone if that makes you feel comfortable and have fun! So, 나는 아직 긴장돼요. 근데 다리 말할 수 있습니다. It is important to keep in mind that this is trying to do worse first by helping you move away from the insecurity point. It's hard to learn if you're there, so be patient and take your time to recover before showing off your new confidence and skills. Do you have any other alter egos you use in your daily life? Let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Yeah.